The moon has a lot of looks, and each one happens for a reason. It takes the moon about 29 and a half days to orbit around the Earth. And during this time, the sun illuminates the moon from varying angles, which creates the shadow effect that we see here on Earth. At the start of each lunar cycle, the moon is between the Earth and the sun. This is called a new moon. The side of the moon visible from Earth is not illuminated, and therefore we can't see it. As the angle between the moon and the sun increases, so does the amount of moon we're able to see. After the new moon, it enters the waxing crescent phase, where we can see 1 to 49% of the moon. When it reaches 50% illumination, it becomes a first quarter moon, which is kind of confusing, but we'll roll with it. Next is the waxing gibbous phase, which means we can see about half to almost all of the moon. And finally, we get to see the big cheese. We get one glorious night of full moon, and then the illumination starts to fade. After a full moon, we see the waning phase, which is the opposite of waxing. The moon follows the same illumination pattern, just flipped, with the final phase being the waning crescent. Then it starts all over again with the new moon. If you're in the northern hemisphere, a waxing moon will be illuminated on the right side, while a waning moon will be illuminated on the left. It's the opposite in the southern hemisphere. So now you know, the next time you see a waxing moon, a full moon is right around the corner. You can catch new episodes of Spacecrafts every Wednesday. In this episode, we'll explain what happens when the sun explodes and the potential fallout for Earth. Thanks for watching, and make sure to subscribe.